tied at 2-2 for first in the NFC East. And the Eagles, who many picked to win the division, are 1-3. Skip Bayless, this division completely up for grabs. Who is in control right now of the NFC East?
Because I'm objective about my team as opposed to other people on this show. Mm-hmm. I'm going to just lay it on the line for both of you.
Please do.
You're a real New York Giants fan.
Thank you.
You're a faux New York Giants fan.
Whatever.
But that's
Steelers
okay.
Steelers fan, yeah.
Okay.
Connecticut,
fan.
Oklahoma
okay.
City. Y'all have no credibility. Anyway,
here we go. Okay, I'm going to give you New York Giants today. And I'm going to tell you, your team is about to jump out to a commanding lead in the NFC East. Because your team has won two straight games. Mm-hmm. Won it, obviously, at Buffalo yesterday very impressively. And you are about to beat San Francisco. You're about to go to Philly and win. You're going to beat my Cowboys at home. You're going to go to New Orleans and win. And you go to Tampa Bay and win. And you're going to open up at 7-2, a 3 or 4 game lead over the rest of the field in the NFC East. My Cowboys, I'm sorry, I'm just going to be honest about it. They're about to lose to Tom Brady. They're about to lose at the Giants. They're about to lose to the Seahawks at home. And I think, because the Eagles do owe them one now. Mm-hmm. I think they'll lose to the Eagles, who always play well at Jerry World. Obviously, the Eagles owe them. The Seahawks owe them from last year. And the Giants owe them from opening night, a game the Giants should have won and couldn't close that deal. That was an accident waiting to happen for Eli. So my point is, my Cowboys are about to plummet to 2-6. Can they climb out of that hole if Romo comes back all the way down the schedule for the Dolphins game? I just don't know, because I think they're going to wind up 3-6 going to the Dolphins. Mm-hmm. And then I don't know what's going to happen from there. Your Giants are going to have such a commanding lead. Could they go 3-3 down the stretch as my Cowboys win their last 7? Because that's what it's going to take to catch the Giants.
Skip Bayless, I'd love to disagree with you. Actually, I'm lying. I wouldn't at all. I'd love to agree with you, and I do. Because I think that the Giants could have the potential to run away with this division, not just for all the things that you mentioned, even though you left out the fact that they got the worst passing defense in the NFL right now. They got to address that because they ranked 32nd in yards allowed in the passing game.
And the fewest sacks in the NFL.
Exactly.
5.
So the combination of you not getting to the quarterback combined with some holes in your secondary, I don't think leaves the Giants in a really strong position. But I will tell you this. Two of the reasons I have, we can go to all three. Philadelphia Eagles, I mean, let's face reality. They look like a shell of what they're supposed to be. There are 9 quarters out of the first, 14, 15 in the NFL that Chip Kelly has gone scoreless. His teams are going scoreless. I mean, it's just an absolute travesty right now. I think he's got like 3 points outside of New York Jets mm-hmm. game, like 3 points in the first half. I mean, it makes no sense whatsoever. I don't know what the hell's going on in Philadelphia. He clearly made too many changes. Mm-hmm. He was doing things, trying to be the lone ranger mm-hmm. and do things his way, and it's costing him right now. Let's look at that. Then we look at the Redskins. I like what I'm seeing from the Redskins. I loved what I saw from Kirk Cousins yesterday because I certainly don't believe in him when the bright lights are on. But he showed up yesterday in a big time moment, and he deserves to be commended for that. That touchdown to Pierre Garçon, that drive itself, I think he did some good things, remained composed, didn't throw any interceptions. A couple of risky throws he did to the side that made mm-hmm. me a bit nervous. But outside of that, I thought he did a really good job. Where I lose it with the Redskins is their schedule. Your next 2 road games are at Atlanta and at the New York Jets. I could see the Redskins potentially losing both games. Not because their defense won't show up to some degree,
yeah.
but because offensively, I think those 2 defenses can get the better of Kirk Cousins. And suddenly, we're not talking about Washington right now. The Redskins deserve a lot of credit. I love what I see when they run the ball effectively. I think they're a different team. When they run the ball a lot, I think they're a different team. All right, but the problem is that I don't know if they're wise enough to do it continuously. When I think about Alfred Morris right now, I'm saying to myself, why not give this guy the ball more? He's averaging about 4 yards a carry. Matt Jones is at 4.7 yards a carry. Why not give him the ball more? So those are questions that I have about the mm-hmm. Redskins, not to mention their defense. When I look at the Giants, what they're doing, their defense, despite their struggles in the passing game, their defense has been surprisingly solid for the most part.
It has.
When I look at Victor Cruz and the fact that he hasn't played yet, and they've been able to do what they've been able to do offensively, three-headed monster in the backfield. Mm-hmm. Then you got Odell Beckham Jr. with Reuben Randle having stepped up. Mm-hmm. The offensive line not as anemic as it has been in the past. Yep. And you have an experienced quarterback.
Yep.
There's a lot of
Dwayne Harris, a nice new piece.
That's right. There's
Dallas
a lot
Cowboy.
Of people.
Yep.
That's right. There's a lot of people that don't believe in Sam Bradford.
Mm-hmm.
The jury is still out on Kirk Cousins, even though you and I don't believe that's the case. We believe he's allergic to the bright lights.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And of course, Brandon Whedon is their quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys, even though he did not play badly.
Mm-hmm.
But the point is, if I got to bet my money, this Eli Manning, who's Mr. Steady.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this dude hasn't missed a start in practically a decade. He plays every game.
Mm-hmm.
He's there. He's all-reliable. And I think when you look at it from that perspective, you got to roll with the Giants right now as to them being the biggest threat to knocking off the Cowboys in the NFC East in terms of the division champions.
Mm-hmm. Do you agree with me they're about to take a commanding lead in the division?
I think they'll continue to win. I would say so, because I think that the Redskins could potentially lose their next two games. And I definitely think that Dallas is going to lose to New England. So I don't want to say commanding, because the Giants started out 0-2, so they got some ground to make mm-hmm. up. Plus, they lost to Dallas along the way, so they have some ground to make up. But do I think that the Giants can find themselves in first place at some juncture in the immediate future? Yes, I do. I'm talking about sole possession in first place. Yes,
okay,
I can see that.
I'm going to be much bolder. I'm just looking at the next five games for each of the teams.
Okay.
Now, Dallas has a bye, so only four games will mm-hmm. be played in the five-week stretch.
Yep.
The Giants are going to win five in a row, which would make it seven in a row.
Mm-hmm.
So that would make them 7-2. Washington will lose at Atlanta, at the Jets, and then in two more weeks at New England. So they've got three out of four games that they could lose and will lose, I think. So they'll go 4-5 in this stretch. Then Philly has three winnable games in their next five,
mm-hmm.
and I think they're not terrible. They're just not what we thought they were going to be.
They're not a team.
They're a different team in the second half.
The Philadelphia Eagles have a lot of talent.
I don't know why they start so slow.
The Philadelphia Eagles have a lot of talent.
Mm-hmm.
Let's be clear about that. But they're not a team. As constructed, it
okay.
doesn't make sense to have those pieces
all
together
right.
if you want to do what Chip Kelly says he wanted
so
to do.
So I'm still going to give them three of their next five.
Mm-hmm.
That would make the Giants 7-2.
Okay.
Philly and Washington 4-5, and it would make my Cowboys 2-6. Okay, now think of the gap, 7-2 all the way down to 4-5. So that's a three-game lead after five more games. That's what's going to happen here. And then we'll see if they can hang on the second half of the year.
Okay.
If Romo and Dez come
it's
back.
It's very possible, Skip.
I'm cool with it,
very
Skip.
Possible.
Mm-hmm.
Over the last 4 years, every team in that division has won the NFC East, so we will see what happens this year. Clay Matthews takes aim at Colin Kaepernick in more ways than one on Sunday. Was it fair to call out San Fran's quarterback? We'll discuss that next. And we're here for your Monday motivation. Stephen A. is fired up to respond to Kevin Durant, and Skip has a strong response to his guy from Vandy beating the Raiders. Check out our Instagram page right now so you can see everything we're touching on at the desk today.